If we don't have something solid in our life, we don't have something to ground us, then we get distracted by something less than who we truly are, you know?
Welcome to episode number 27 with the warrior sage, Mr. Satyen Raja.
Welcome to the Hustle to Greatness podcast. I'm your host, Luke Sismbath, and each week I'll be bringing special guests who will inspire and give us step-by-step action tips on how to hustle our way to greatness. My mission here is to help you to call the shots in your own life and to live your life on your own terms. Follow me on this journey to greatness while picking the minds of these brilliant entrepreneurs. Let's get you from being good to great.
So welcome to the show, Satyen. Very happy to have you on the show.
Thanks for having me, Luke. Looking forward to connecting and seeing what we can do to raise everyone's greatness today.
I'm looking forward to this session because it's a little twist from what I'm used to. I'm usually doing the interviewing, but we're going to get into a session on how you could up-level my greatness.
Awesome. Yeah, we'll have a lot of fun. And everyone else who's involved today will have a I would love to have everyone go through an experiential exercise, which is going to up-level their mindset as well as their core being to have themselves to be even more like the people that they admire in their life.
Awesome. Awesome. That's, I'm really looking forward to it. So let's get right into it, Satyen. You're the founder of Warrior Sage. Now, can you tell us a little bit about that and the whole philosophy behind Warrior Sage?
Yes, certainly. Well, I started off in martial arts as a young fellow, and I grew deeply, you know, I deeply immersed myself in this whole world of really mastering my own mind and my body through kung fu and different martial arts, Brazilian jiu-jitsu. And what I found is that the mindset of the warrior and the sage, the warrior is that action-oriented, make things happen, take no prisoners, be successful in spite of all fears. We know that warrior mindset, which has really propelled a lot of successful people. But there's another side, which is the sage. The sage is the wisdom within us, is the part that's connected to spirit, the part that's connected to our families, the part that's connected to a higher vision, a higher purpose, more than just putting dollars in our pockets, you know? So for me, the blend of warrior and sage is something that I learned from my martial arts teachers and that I've carried forward in the businesses that I've started and ran since I've been a youngster.
Cool. So you've been, how long have you been doing martial arts for?
About 35 years now.
35 years, as old as I am, as long as I've been around. Awesome. So that's very interesting.
Well, what I was going to say is paradoxically, at the same time, I also started working, you know, with my father's and my parents' businesses at the same time. So I was doing martial arts and learning business. So I was able to blend both the wisdoms that come with both sides, you know?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And there's a thing, because I've been doing martial arts pretty much all my life as well. I was in the more traditional, well, I wouldn't say traditional Wing Chun, but more the modern Wing Chun when I was younger, and have moved on to, you know, Muay Thai and some of the grappling arts. And there's always been this type of warrior building that I did not realize I was doing. So there's a lot of character building involved in that. And I'm assuming that's where you're getting from a very young age, yourself training in martial arts, have developed that and now have put it together into a personal development type of philosophy that you live by and also teach your students.
Exactly. You know, the archetype of the warrior is within all of us. We all have a part in us that is indomitable, a part in us that can stand up and face calamity, face challenge, and succeed in spite of anything. And we just have to cultivate that, strengthen that, love that, nurture that part in ourselves, and honor ourselves. In today's society, the role of the enlightened warrior or the warrior sage is taking a back seat to just success from what society sees it to be. Or what we think success is. But to me, the warrior sage principles are timeless. They were around thousands of years ago, and people who lived by them grew strength and honor and perseverance and clarity and wisdom. those values, those principles are still alive today. And I feel even more so needed to embrace, because if we don't have something solid in our life, we don't have something to ground us, then we get distracted by something less than who we truly are, you know?
Mm-hmm. And I was listening to my friend Jim Harshaw's interview with the episode with yourself. And there's one piece that really stuck out to me was, correct me if I'm wrong here, I'm probably going to butcher it, but we're all in this, you know, this hustle stage in our life. Everybody's, you know, on a hustle and bustle, push, push, push. But we just need to get back into, you know, having that intensity and that focus, getting things done, but in a more spiritual and calm way. Now, can you reiterate that again? Because I don't know if I'm explaining it right here.
I get what you're saying. Totally. Well, you know, if we just use the warrior, use our yang side. You know, in Chinese, they call it yang. And the opposite of that is yin. Yang is masculine intensity. Feminine is the nurturance of the yin side. And our society has been so fully focused on the yang side of achievement, especially in business. Most business people that I know who've reached a level of financial success have done well and have prospered, but at a cost. I've been there myself. You know, I remember I've grown, you know, multi-million dollar companies, and I've done really well on many levels, but I remember that the problem is that there's a backfire. There's a balancing force if you're just overly driven and keep pushing, pushing, pushing. And the returning force, or if you want to call it the blind spot that a lot of successful people don't see on their journey to greater success, is that their families could be deteriorating because they're putting so much energy and time and involvement in their business that, in my case, my wife was like, hey, where are you? You're married to your business, and what about me? I almost lost my wife years ago I was not balanced. I almost, you know, lost my connection with my children, my teenage children, because I was so dedicated to business. I didn't nurture and nourish and feed home with my heart, my soul, my presence. So that's where the sage comes in. And the sage realizes that, you know what, you're going to die one day. I'm going to die one day. We're all going to die one day. And rather than just focus on the ever pushing, pushing, pushing and hustling, 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 we've got to take care of our backyard, our health. I call them the five freedoms: faith, family, finance, fitness, and fun. When we can have all of those and we cultivate all of those, then we become the full expression of success, not just a partial expression, which leads to calamity and the toppling of many successful people, you know?
Right. So I like your five Fs. This is very, very intriguing. And I totally agree. However, you know, there is a challenge for myself as well, you know, to balance all of that. And I'm sure for most people. Now, how would one go about it? Because most people that are listening to the show, you know, they're about the hustle, and you know, the term hustle is, you know, being shot around a lot, and it's like, you know, this is this whole thing about, you know, I'll sleep till when I'm dead, you know, so I keep hustling 24/7 type of deal. Now, for those types that, you know, might need to maybe balance it out a bit and get that sage involved, how do you do this? How do you wind down that hustle and keep it focused?
I think what needs to happen is we take a look at and give an inventory of our life. And the paradox is, you know, I coach entrepreneurs who are in the multi millions, you know, in their companies. I've taken companies, helped companies go from 5 million to 50 million in worth in a short period of time. And these principles that I'm going to share, they sound counterintuitive to the logical Western-oriented mind of success orientation, but I got to tell you, it works, okay? It works in my life, and it works in the countless lives of others that I work with. So here's the number one principle. The very push that you want to go for, the way to get there faster is by actually lowering the importance that you have on the very thing that you're going for. totally counterintuitive because we've been taught, you know, success at all costs, stay up all night. But you know what the problem is that your body will break down, your mind will break down. You may get more money in the bank for short term, but people won't trust you because you look harried, you look nervous, your presence is filled with anxiety, your eyes look like you need sleep. People of higher net worth who are more balanced, who are wanting to make a deal with someone influential, who's going to help their business grow or have a good relationship with, they're going to push aside the people who are out of balance. They can see it. They can feel it. So you may get business with other people who are neurotic and crazed, but the ones who are in a place of depth, you look at it like a Richard Branson. Look how calm he is, always carrying a deep smile on his face. He's jovial. He's chill. And, you know, it's the new breed of millionaire, which is in another way called a chillionaire, you know? So I believe in this day and age that we can get way further along by becoming a chillionaire in mindset, which is one of the words that one of my mentors, Kevin Nations, uses, chillionaire, to describe someone who's earning well, but at the same time is balanced. And how do we do that? We've got to lower the importance of striving. Lower the importance of the very, okay, I want to make $1 million. Okay, you want to make it, great. Lower the importance on that. Dial it down, Tiger. And then, see, if you just dial it down, then you just become lazy. You'll just become a floaster. We know people who have great intentions but get nothing done. You know what I mean? Lower the importance and then combine that with impeccable, swift follow-through. Impeccable, razor sharp, do exactly what's needed, no more, no less. Do with the highest level of your integrity, highest level of impeccability and quality. Not 90%, not 99%, but 100. And then follow through with absolute clarity, precision, and impeccability, and honor and integrity. So know your vision, know your mission, know what you need to create. Have that strong goal, number one. Number two, lower the importance. I can't stress this enough. Dial down your anxiety, dial down the tiger in you, and then connect with the sage in you. Once you dial down the importance, you activate a higher principle in the universe. And then the universe starts working with you rather than you forcing it. Then the third step is, after you've lowered your importance, after you know what your goal is and you're clear on it and you're going for it, now act with impeccable precision and follow through. Those three, know what you want, which is what many of us know about. We don't need more lectures on this. We know how to visualize and go for our goals. Number two is the secret missing ingredient that's known by Taoist masters, known by martial art masters. The better you get, the less power you use. The older you get, the less power you use. And you use more smarts, you use more wisdom, and you become more of an impeccable being. So those are the three main steps to making a big difference in it, you know?
Mm-hmm. I really like lowering the importance because, I've been in sales and marketing for a pretty long span of time. And at one point in my career, I was just burning the candles at both ends. I would just be on my BlackBerry whenever an email notification came in, a lead came in, I'd follow up right away. And it just killed me. And I was also, having two side things going on at the same time because I had this goal that I was trying to achieve. But it was, I put that work to the hustle. I put too much importance into it that I ended up burning out. And I totally agree with doing that because now in my career, I have that goal set and I have lowered the importance. And hey, look, this is something I want to reach. But you know what? I'm not going to be anxious and and very fuzzy minded about it because I'm so excited. I'm just going to calm down and do the precision, the swift follow through, which is cool because I never really broke it down this way. But just speaking to you, Satyen, this is really enlightening. Now it's kind of like going back to martial arts, right? When you're focusing on a certain attack, and you're going there calmly, your goal, you're lowering your importance that, okay, if I don't make it, that's fine, but I'm going to make it, right? And then following up with precision, act with precision, and you end up getting there, right? So it's very cool stuff.
Well, you know, it's like the whole principle of hustle, but without the hassle.
I love that. Oh, I love that. I'm going to use that from hashtag. I started the hashtag and oh, that's awesome. That's great.
Hustling is good. That's the goal. That's being clear on your goals. That's finding, hey, what do I really want to attain in life? You know, one of the things that I do with you know, the folks that I train and coach is I make sure we get clear on what they want the money for. So if they want money, what do they want the money for? So I'll ask people, what do you, I want, you know, my goal is $1 million, you know, as an example, right? I'll go, well, what are you going to buy with that? And they're, well, I'm not sure. I go, okay, let's break it right down. What are, first of all, instead of the stuff, I say before the stuff, before the actual physical stuff, what are the life experiences you wish to have? The jazz. And some folks will say, well, I'd love to have, you know, vacations with my family often. I'd love to have, go see the world. I'd love to eat at amazing restaurants. You know, whatever your joys and passions are in terms of life experiences, when you make a list of those deeply, then the second list should be what are the things that you want to purchase? Because for me, there's only one purpose of money, and that's to purchase life experiences. There's life experiences you can have without money, of course, many of them, but there's also incredible amount of experiences you can have with money. So know what life experiences you want to have. Then paradoxically, what happens is it's so much easier to earn that money because you've activated the sage component in your consciousness, which is now looking for ways for you to attain the results of what money can buy you rather than money itself.
I really like how you get into listing the life experiences that you want to attain, because when you attach a feeling to anything, it becomes more, you become more connected to it, right? And when you're striving to achieve that, I feel like you're visualizing yourself being in that spot, having that experience, and you tend to subconsciously or even, well, consciously, but your subconscious kicks into high gear as well, and helps you, gives you a little kick, especially with those experiences, right?
Exactly. Yeah.
That's awesome, Satyen. So now the session that you want to put me through today or have me experience, now, what is this? Is this something that you do for your clients? And what is this going to do to me?
Well, first of all, I use, you know, as a martial artist has many tools, same as a, you know, craftsman has many tools. So do coaches and leaders and guides. And this particular process is from my Accelerated Evolution Academy. I have an academy where I train physicians, business coaches, business leaders in methods that make radical shifts in consciousness very quickly, help remove obstacles, business mindset obstacles, help remove emotional challenges that keep us from going to the next step. So what I'm going to run today right now, guide us all through, and I'm welcoming everyone to experience this, is I call it the Superman integration. What we're going to do is I'm going to ask you to pick an icon, someone that you admire in business, in hustle, someone who's successful, but not just with money, but also has a lifestyle that you would go, wow, you know, there's something about this person. One of my favorites that I've done this on is Elon Musk. And what I admire about Elon Musk as the CEO of Tesla and, you know, SpaceX and other companies is what I love about him is not only is he working on increasing business, he's also aiming to change the world in a better way and make a big leaps for humanity. You know, he has that care and that big thinking. For someone else, it could be like a Richard Branson, who is just so relaxed and happy and, you know, the pinnacle of a trillionaire. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a method where we're going to feel the icon, the person that we admire the most in their highest capacity, doing, you know, doing their thing at their best. Because what we're going to do is we're going to integrate that quality into our own self and become one with that. And to do that, we're going to feel the icon for a few seconds, about 10, 15 seconds full on. I want you to imagine you're right there in front of them, see them at their liveliest, activating their power to their best. And then I'm going to say, let go of that. And now I want you to feel the other side. I want you to feel you at your top game. Try to remember a time when you've been at your top game. And then when you're there, I'm going to ask you to say something about that into the space. And everyone at home, I want you to do the same thing. We're going to feel your icon, the person you respect, because we're going to integrate the quality that you wish to see bloom stronger inside yourself. We're going to go back and forth, back and forth. And then I'm going to have you feel both of them at the same time while you're taking a deep breath in and out. And when you do that, what's going to happen is the two sides will start to merge. They'll get closer and closer. We're going to do this a couple of times, the whole sequence. And by the end of this, it shouldn't take more than 7 minutes to 10 minutes max. What's going to happen is that you will become one with the very person that you admire, and the quality that you wish to see stronger in yourself, you'll become one with. So it's pretty cool.
Awesome. This sounds, I'm very interested to see how this process comes to fruition.
Okay, let's dive into it.
Perfect. So the one thing I'm having a challenge with right now is thinking of an entrepreneur. The only person that comes to mind for me right now that keeps sticking in my head is Sylvester Stallone.
Awesome.
Yeah, I think he has his own movie. I think, I don't know if you could batch him into the entrepreneurs, I believe.
Sure, for sure. So what is the quality about Sylvester Stallone that you admire, you respect, that you'd like to see grow stronger or wake up inside of you?
Well, his tenacity. I mean, I have the tenacity, but Stallone, his is on a next level, because I don't believe I've experienced what he's experienced in his life as of yet, seeing that he's been gone through quite a bit trying to get Rocky started, and, you know, being told that he was no good and that he was, not competent enough to play the lead role. So the tenacity, the character that he has, like this, that fight that he has, and just moving on and keep on moving, you know?
Exactly. Okay, that's awesome. Everyone at home, I want you to find the person that you admire, whoever it is. All right. And I want you to feel Sylvester Stallone and the person that you admire fully. See them at their best. See them exemplifying the quality you wish to experience. So magnify that. And when you're ready, Luke, just say something about it. Anything that comes up.
Yeah, influence.
Okay. Excellent. Well done. Next, I want you to feel you at your top game. Try to remember a time, top game, and then say something about that.
Inner power.
Okay, well done. Well done. Okay, next. Now I want you to feel just Sylvester Stallone, or those of you at home, pick the person you admire, and once again, magnify what you feel. See them full on. And then say something about it into the space, whatever comes up. It could be a sense, a word, feelings, whatever comes up.
Inspiring the world.
Okay, well done. Just continue like this. You're doing excellent. Now I want you to feel the other side. I want you to feel you at your top game. When you're there, say something about it.
Again, powerful.
Yeah. Well done. Okay, once again, I want you to feel your icon. I want you to feel who you admire most, Sylvester Stallone, in your case, Luke. Everyone at home, feel them. And if there's any part of them you haven't visualized before or seen, totally dive into it. Magnify it, dramatize it. In fact, the stronger you make this, the more powerful you'll integrate this quality. And when you're ready, you can say something about it into the space.
Fulfilled.
Well done. Okay, so now what we're going to do is I want you to feel your icon and yourself at the same time while you take a slow, deep breath in and out and share what's happening between the two sides.
It's kind of like a meeting of the minds now.
Yes.
Yeah, so what's going on is my top self and his and the quality I like about him, and or what that the word that came out, that came to mind when I was feeling his influence was influence. We're starting to brainstorm now and, you know, getting together and inspiring the world. pretty much, because that's something that I really admire about Stallone, and he communicates his messages through movies, and there's always a lesson learned in almost every scene that he does, especially in Rocky.
Exactly. Okay, awesome. All right, now we're going to do this again, this time a little faster. So do your best to feel just alone or the person that you admire. Really dive into it, magnify it, dramatize it, and then go ahead and say something about it into the space.
In tune with his fear, knowing how to control his fear, but fearless.
Okay, awesome. All right, now feel yourself at your top game and then say something about it.
Control, self-control.
All right, well done. Feel Stallone and the person you admire the most at home. Feel them fully. We're going to go really fast on this one, a little faster. So feel them fully, and when something comes up, just say it into the space.
Strong, strength.
Okay, well done. Okay, now feel yourself in this here and now moment. You in your power.
Inspired.
Excellent. Feel Stallone again, or the person you admire. Say something about it.
Pig-headed determination.
Well done. Now, feel you and your icon at the same time while you take a slow, deep breath in and out and share what's happening between the two.
Joining forces and molding into one. Become integrating into the Superman.
Exactly. Most of you have already integrated. Some of you, we're going to go one more step to lock it in. All right, so one more round. This one's going to go a little smoother and faster, and this one's going to lock it in. So everyone, feel the person that you admire, that you would like to really dive into and pick up that quality inside yourself. Feel them fully, and then say something about it into the space.
At peace.
Well done. Okay, feel yourself at the top of your game. And say something about it.
Fulfilled.
Awesome. Feel your icon once again, and then say something about it.
Grab the bull by its horns.
Well done. Feel yourself once again.
Attacking life.
Excellent. And now everyone, I want you to feel both at the same time, you and your respected figure, and take a slow, deep breath in and out. And share what's happening between the two.
Again, that mold, the molding into one, that superhero icon that I have in my mind, I guess, that I've probably had this picture, this vision of a powerful human being growing up.
Excellent. Have you become one with them?
Yeah.
Excellent. So go ahead and expand that oneness infinitely in front of you, behind you, to the sides of you, above and below you. And everyone can answer these questions out loud as well into the space. So what was good about going through this for you, Luke?
Well, it unleashed a lot of things that I wanted to emulate, especially with, again, back to Stallone's life, his journey, all the obstacles that he's went through. I mean, I've been through quite a few myself. And I guess that's something that I admire in people. Out of the icons that he asked me to choose from, he was one of them, right? I would have chose Bruce Lee. However, that's, he's been gone for a while now, but, so for me, it unleashed really what I admire, what I want to emulate in my life, which I am already doing, but, maybe I want to have that, more of that strength. I guess I'm seeing that other people can handle it.
Yes.
Much better. I might be wrong, but I don't know. But it's just something that I really admire in somebody's character.
Excellent. What's good about this for others, this integration of you and Stallone? And what's good about this for others? How will it help others?
Well, the integration with myself and Stallone, the end goal, the thing that I really admire about him and molding it into my character is, one of the things, it wasn't just about striving and having that determination, but also his determination to, influence the world as well. And that's something that I want to do. And I hope I'm doing through this podcast as well as other channels that I'm a part of. So influence was a big one. So influencing the world into, you know, living a more fulfilled life and to live a life that's real for them, right? Not being a puppet. I might get in trouble for saying that, but I mean, not being a puppet and, you know, just going through what society is telling us to do, right? Doing what you want to do and doing it on your terms.
Exactly. Okay. What's valuable about this integration, this oneness?
What I took from that, the value here is, you know, I just took Stallone's power, the attributes that I admire from him. And I absorbed it within myself. It's kind of like absorbing the superpowers of, like what you see in the comic books. It's kind of like, you know, you're adding an extra power into your arsenal.
Exactly. All right. And tell me, what's an action that you can take, everyone, from this mindset, from this unity, this oneness, that's going to just propel you more forward in life in a way that's hustle without hassle?
Interesting. Hustle without hassle. Going through this exercise, you know, being at one and having that power that I really, you know, I wouldn't say power, it's a strength from within, right? That type of power, not a power of controlling people, but power within myself. I feel very at peace about myself going through the hustles now.
Yes.
And without having the stress of, you know, what I had years back and, you know, just go, go, go. And being in a kind of an anxious state is what I was at. Now I feel like doing this exercise, I might have to do it more than once. What will help me in calming that hustle anxiety and calming it down and going through the motions and going, attacking with precision, like you were mentioning earlier.
Exactly. Well done. Take a couple of deep breaths. And if any of you were just sitting on the sidelines observing this time, because it's a podcast, I recommend that you go through it again and actually do this. Find someone that you really dig, that you'd like to awaken and infuse some positive, you know, capacity. And that's what this process will do. And Luke, you can go ahead and do this again with Bruce Lee.
I love it. I love it. Thank you for that. I really appreciate that session. Now, Satyen, I know you gave us a lot of great tips here, and you even gave us a glimpse of, you know, what you do and how you help people uncover and unleash their true power and unleash that warrior within. So is there any other steps that we can take, like something that's going to, you know, like an immediate action that we can take to start uncovering our inner warrior?
Well, you know, the guided process I just took you through, I suggest everyone go through that once or twice. That'll be a very powerful step. And then the next step is to really feel into, as I shared earlier, and actually write down what are the fruits of your success? What life experiences do you wish to purchase, to have, and get clear on that and have fun with that? Get together if you have a spouse or a friend or someone that cares about you. Do it with them. You can go for a walk, go to a park, go in nature, clear your mind, and then write down what are the life experiences that really jazz you, really move you. And then you can reverse engineer that and figure out how much that would cost you. Now you know really what type of income you need to make, and that's going to set up your subconscious mind and your conscious mind for greater success, more fluidity, and more precision in the attainment of your goals.
That's great. That's great. And I just wanted to add something as well with the session that we just had. It really, I think it's a really great exercise on anybody that has a challenge of doing that investigative into their inner self, right? Doing this, it's like an awareness drill, because I know it was tough for me at first because I was just, I didn't really realize who I really was, what I was really thinking and what my beliefs really were. But I think this is a great exercise to start unleashing that and uncovering your inner self and seeing who you really are and see if you really like it or not. And if you don't, then you could change it. I don't know if that's the goal for what this is for, Satyen, but for me, that's what I took out of it.
Everyone's going to take a different thing out of it, and that's awesome. So you're right. You know, the fact that you did this and you went into it is what's going to up-level you. Look, if we're going to be successful business people, we got to be in touch with what's cutting edge. And, you know, when I'm coaching top MMA athletes or high-level CEOs, I use these are the same principles. They go through the same thing that I just took you through to up-level. And up-leveling our minds, up-leveling our consciousness. We got to go from peak performance. The next stage is peak consciousness. And by consciousness, I mean the ability to flow in your mind, not get hung up, not get stuck, and to look at things from above rather than always being mired down by stress and struggle and unconscious hassle. You know what I mean? I love hustle, but I love the hustle that I love hassle-free hustle. And I think that's where we're going to go next. I think the next generation of entrepreneurs are embracing this already. And whoever's listening to this gets to be cutting edge. And, you know, as long as you do the work, you know.
Perfect. Thanks a lot, Satyen. Now, can you tell us where, I know you mentioned it earlier in the show, but can you direct our listeners to how they can find you and if they want to dig deeper into their warrior sage?
Absolutely. Well, my website is warriorsage.com, warriorsage.com. And, you know, I hold different retreats based on sex, power, and money. Very intensive, like a dojo for those who want to master, you know, those three elements, sexuality and relationships, power and influence to make greater influence, as well as to master the art of warrior sage money creation. How do we create finances? Or if we're really doing well, how do we make it so that we're at ease and peace and that we're not struggling all the time or in chaos? So just go to warriorsage.com. There's information there on how to become part of our community and how to be invited to our exclusive events.
Awesome. Thanks a lot for the session, Satyen. For everybody, we just got an arsenal of tools on how we can up-level our greatness, up-level our hustle without the hassle. I love that. I'm going to keep using that, Satyen. Thanks a lot.
Absolutely. Hey, it's been a pleasure, Luke, and I really feel your heart. I feel the care that you're doing this podcast from, and those of you who are listening, you've got a really good guide here to support you. So listen up and take his advice and listen to all the great people that he brings on.
Thanks a lot, Satyen. You're an inspiration.
All the best, Luke, and everyone at home. All the best, and ignite passion, live freedom, and embody love.
Wow, what an episode. That was something else, something else. Really got me feeling, you know, quite vulnerable, but also at the same time, rebuilding on that vulnerability, kind of like in the army where, you know, they break you down to build you up. Whereas here is, you know, he peeled so many layers in me. Well, he helped me do that, and I did that on my own, but he helped guide me do that, and went to some really deep levels and made me find out more about myself. So that was very interesting. So, guys, if you are interested in contacting or learning more about Satyen, yeah, go check him out, satyenraja.com. So that's SatyenRaja.com, and you can see what he's all about, a little bit more about what he's all about, because you guys already had a little experience of what Mr. Satyen Raja can do, Mr. Warrior Sage. So until next time, guys, keep hustling.